Okay, here we go. The field of racers was going to be tougher than other years. Brian Christopherson. Brian, comma, it's a list. Brian. Doug. And Kevin were all in shape. I like the idea. I liked the idea of a competitive race. I had been beat by Dave Hoagland. And that year, you know what? I'm gonna take that and out of there, and I'm gonna put that comma. That year, I didn't have a chance. I don't like the ands. That I put an and here because it was part of a list. And I didn't put a comma there. If you look back at that, you'll notice it's Brian, comma, Doug, and Kevin, and is the comma in the list there, but you'll use it in a list. That year, I didn't have a chance. Period. Dave is just too tough. Dave is just that strong. I'll change it to that strong. This year was different. I'm going to change that. The next year, I won easily. No one offered a challenge. This year it was going to be a race. Now, as I do this, you guys, I hope you're noticing some of this stuff I'm taking from the very last questions the interviewer asked. This is an explanation of last year's race. I'm kind of taking care of that right now. And now I'm getting a little bit into the theme, too. I like the idea. I'll probably come back to this at the end again. But I like the idea of that I'm kind of hinting at the theme in the beginning. This year is going to be a race. It's going to be close. And then I'm going to go back to my draft again. I've got that in. And now I might start. A lot of the words won't change now. I think of the field for sure. Dave Hoagland was not there. Larry Oban. Okay. So the main competition with you others, tell us about the story. Should I go to the start? This year was going to be a race. I knew, on the draft, I said I was confident. I think I'm going to write, I knew it was going to be close. And now I'm going to add something that wasn't in the draft. I want to talk again about the setting. I'm going to say at the start, it was simply beautiful. A November morning where we could wear shorts and short sleeves. The racers were simply, I've already used simply. I don't want to be repetitive. See how I use simply there? Were or excited. I don't want to be repetitive. Excited to ride and such. Beautiful weather. Now, today, what I want you to kind of pay attention to is I really went back to my draft and I got the theme going in the beginning. You might bump some of this stuff around. You'll go to the draft and back to this and be bumping it back and forth. I also was paying attention to where I was being repetitive. I don't want to use words again and again. I want to find other words. When I'm being spelling machine for you, use me as a thesaurus. If you've used a word multiple times, you can ask, what's another word for this? Because the reader ands, thens, buts, and if you use a word like excited over and over and over again, change some of them to thrilled, exhilarated, fascinated, you know, because if you use, what happens is you got to think about your reader. And you don't want them to start to wear out on a word like, oh, they've used excited, you know, 50 times in this. They've got to come up with something else. So when you're reading your draft and you're going to your final draft, really ask yourself, have I used that word again and again? And then we need to find something else for you. And we can find another word for you. But even here, you'll notice, and I know this happened to Caden too, I am not started even the race yet, and I'm well into the story. I'm trying to set it up. The setting, who is there, what am I feeling about it, and I haven't even got into the race itself. I'm getting there. We're about to go. And once I get into the race, this is going to be easier because a lot of this in my draft, this is where I start to get these big chunks. You know, they become giant, you know, just really big with questions that you guys ask. That I'll be able to use, but this will become big, big chunks of writing that'll go into the story, changed a little bit to sound a little bit better and maybe get some of the repetition out of there. But the start is a little bit trickier. I'm getting setting established. I'm getting characters established. I'm getting the feel of it all emotionally, what's going on, a little bit of history with it. So there is some layers to add right at the start to kind of get underneath it. So that's what we're working on today. Thanks.